UK's earthquake time bomb, the hidden threat. What if Britain's peaceful countryside is actually sitting on a geological time bomb that could devastate millions of lives overnight? Be sure to keep watching until the end of this video, because I'm going to reveal the shocking truth about why UK earthquake experts are quietly preparing for something they won't publicly discuss. A catastrophic seismic event that could make the 2011 Japan tsunami look like a gentle tremor. So don't click away. You won't want to miss these terrifying geological secrets that could change everything you think you know about living in Britain. Picture this. It's February 27, 2008, and you're peacefully sleeping in your bed somewhere in England. Suddenly, at 12:56 a.m., your entire house starts violently shaking. Books fly off shelves, windows crack, and car alarms scream across the countryside. This wasn't some distant rumble. It was the Market Rasen earthquake, a 5.2 magnitude monster that jolted the entire nation awake and sent a chilling message that most people chose to ignore. But here's what's absolutely terrifying. That earthquake wasn't an anomaly. It was a warning shot. While most Brits casually dismiss earthquakes as something that happens over there in places like California or Japan, the uncomfortable truth is that the UK experiences around 200 to 300 earthquakes every single year. Most are too small to feel, but they're happening constantly beneath your feet, building pressure in ways that scientists are only beginning to understand. The 2008 Market Rasen quake didn't just rattle windows. It fundamentally changed how seismologists view Britain's seismic future. For the first time in decades, an earthquake strong enough to cause actual structural damage had struck the heart of England, injuring people and forcing the evacuation of an entire police station. The tremors were felt from Edinburgh to London, proving that when Britain's geological giants decide to move, nowhere is safe. What makes this even more unsettling is that recent decades have shown a disturbing uptick in seismic activity across the British Isles. The seemingly random earthquakes aren't actually random at all. They're following patterns that suggest something much larger is building beneath the surface. You see, most people think Britain is geologically stable because they're not sitting directly on major tectonic plate boundaries like the San Andreas Fault. But that assumption is dangerously naive. The UK is actually caught in a geological squeeze play that's been intensifying for thousands of years. They're being compressed from multiple directions, pushed by the Atlantic Ridge expanding to the west and squeezed by continental drift from the south and east. Even more alarming is the process scientists call post-glacial rebound. During the last ice age, massive glaciers pressed down on northern Britain with unimaginable weight. When those glaciers melted around 10,000 years ago, the land began slowly rising back up, like a compressed sponge expanding. This sounds gradual and harmless, but it's actually creating enormous stress along ancient fault lines that run like hidden scars beneath the entire country. These aren't theoretical concerns. The geological evidence is mounting, and it's genuinely frightening. Ancient fault systems that have been dormant for centuries are showing signs of reactivation. The Highland Boundary Fault, the Southern Uplands Fault, and dozens of smaller fracture systems are all experiencing increased pressure as the Earth's crust continues to adjust and shift. What's particularly disturbing is how unprepared the average British citizen is for seismic disaster. Unlike countries with regular earthquake experience, UK buildings aren't constructed to earthquake-resistant standards. Most homes and historic structures would crumble like sandcastles in a moderate earthquake, let alone a major one. The scientific community has been tracking concerning seismic patterns, but the general public remains blissfully unaware that Britain's geological stability might be an illusion. Every small tremor that rattles through the countryside isn't just an isolated incident. It's part of a larger, more ominous pattern that suggests the UK's seismic reckoning may be approaching faster than anyone wants to admit. The terrifying reality is that UK earthquakes are actually far more dangerous than their continental cousins, and the science behind this will absolutely shock you. Unlike earthquakes in places like California, where buildings are designed to withstand seismic activity and people know what to expect, British earthquakes strike with devastating unpredictability against a population that's completely defenseless. Here's why UK seismic events are uniquely treacherous. British earthquakes occur at relatively shallow depths, typically between 5 and 15 kilometers below the surface. This shallow depth means the seismic energy doesn't have time to dissipate as it travels upward, creating incredibly intense ground shaking that can be felt across hundreds of miles. When the 1884 Colchester earthquake struck with a magnitude of just 4.6, it caused more structural damage than earthquakes twice its size in seismically active regions. The geological factors making UK earthquakes so unpredictable are genuinely alarming. Britain sits on what geologists call a stable craton, ancient rock formations that have been relatively quiet for millions of years. But this stability is deceptive. These ancient rocks are incredibly rigid and brittle, meaning when they finally do break under stress, they fracture catastrophically rather than bending gradually like younger, more flexible geological formations. Recent scientific research has uncovered something absolutely chilling. Climate change might actually be triggering increased seismic activity across Britain. As extreme weather patterns intensify, the rapid changes in atmospheric pressure combined with increased rainfall and flooding are affecting underground water tables and putting additional stress on fault systems. Scientists have documented correlations between severe weather events and subsequent seismic activity, suggesting that our changing climate could be the catalyst that finally triggers the geological time bomb beneath our feet. The ancient fault lines crisscrossing Britain tell a story that should terrify anyone living on these islands. The Highland Boundary Fault stretches for over 240 miles across Scotland, marking the boundary between the Highlands and the Lowlands. This massive geological scar has been responsible for some of Scotland's most destructive earthquakes and remains active today. Similarly, the Church Stretton Fault system runs through Wales and Western England, while the Malvern Liniment cuts through the heart of England like a hidden fracture waiting to split open. What makes these fault systems particularly menacing is their unpredictable reactivation patterns. Unlike plate boundary faults that move consistently, these intraplate faults can remain dormant for centuries before suddenly lurching back to life with devastating force. The 1580 Dover Straits earthquake, which damaged buildings across London and was felt throughout Europe, occurred on a fault system that had shown no significant activity for hundreds of years before unleashing its fury. Historical analysis reveals cyclical patterns in UK seismic activity that are genuinely frightening. Researchers studying earthquake records dating back over 1,000 years have identified roughly 400-year cycles of increased seismic activity followed by periods of relative calm. The last major active period occurred between 1550 and 1750, featuring devastating earthquakes that destroyed churches, toppled chimneys, and created widespread panic across Britain. Here's where it gets really scary. We're currently approaching the 400-year mark since the last major seismic period ended. This means we could be entering a new phase of heightened earthquake activity, and our modern infrastructure is completely unprepared for what's coming. Hey Explorer, if you're looking to expand your knowledge, becoming a member is the perfect choice. You'll gain access to stellar perks like custom badges, exclusive emojis, special discounts, and additional content like bonus videos, exclusive polls, and access to our private Discord group, where you can interact directly with us and other explorers like you. Every perk is designed to make you feel like an essential part of the community. This is a small leap from you, but a giant leap for the channel and for your thirst for knowledge. Join now to take your adventure to a whole new level. The current quiet period might actually be the most dangerous time of all. During seismically active periods, small earthquakes regularly release built-up stress along fault lines. But during quiet periods like the one we're experiencing now, that stress continues accumulating with no release mechanism. It's like a pressure cooker with a blocked valve. Eventually, something has to give, catastrophically. Modern seismic monitoring equipment is detecting micro-earthquakes and subtle ground movements that suggest major fault systems are indeed building towards something significant. The concerning trends in the data show increasing frequency of tiny tremors along previously quiet fault lines, suggesting that the stress buildup may be approaching critical levels. What's particularly unnerving is that, unlike California, where earthquake preparedness is drilled into residents from childhood, most Brits have never experienced anything more than a gentle rumble. When the big one finally hits, the psychological impact alone could be as devastating as the physical destruction, creating mass panic in a population that has no idea how to respond to major seismic disaster. When the inevitable major earthquake finally strikes Britain, the devastation will be unlike anything this nation has ever experienced. Picture London during a magnitude 6.5 earthquake, the Tower Bridge cracking under seismic stress, Victorian buildings pancaking onto crowded streets, and the underground system flooding as century-old tunnels collapse. This isn't science fiction. It's a very real scenario that earthquake engineers have been quietly modeling for years. The catastrophic vulnerability of British infrastructure is genuinely terrifying. Unlike countries with regular seismic activity, UK building codes have never prioritized earthquake resistance. Most structures were built assuming the ground would never move significantly. Georgian terraces, Victorian warehouses, and even many modern office buildings would simply disintegrate under moderate earthquake stress. The unreinforced masonry construction that defies British architecture becomes a death trap when seismic waves start propagating through bedrock. London represents the ultimate nightmare scenario for UK seismic disaster. Over 9 million people live in a city where almost every building predates modern earthquake engineering. The ancient Roman foundations, medieval street layouts, and densely packed urban core create a perfect storm of vulnerability. When seismic waves hit London's clay-rich soil, they'll amplify dramatically, turning the Thames Basin into a seismic echo chamber that could magnify earthquake effects by 300 to 400%. The economic implications are staggering beyond comprehension. A major UK earthquake wouldn't just damage buildings, it would trigger complete economic collapse. The financial district of London handles trillions of pounds in daily transactions. When those servers go offline, when trading floors evacuate, when international confidence in British stability evaporates overnight, the ripple effects could crash global markets. Insurance companies have estimated that a major London earthquake could cause economic losses exceeding £150 billion, making it the most expensive natural disaster in European history. But the economic damage pales compared to the human catastrophe that would unfold. British emergency response systems are woefully inadequate for major seismic disaster. The NHS, already stretched to breaking point, would completely collapse under the sudden influx of thousands of severely injured earthquake victims. Fire services lack the specialized equipment for urban search and rescue operations. Police forces have no experience managing mass casualty seismic events. Recent seismic monitoring data reveals concerning trends that experts are tracking but deliberately not discussing publicly. Gravitational sensors across Britain have detected subtle ground movements that suggest major fault systems are approaching critical stress thresholds. The British Geological Survey's confidential reports, leaked through Freedom of Information requests, show increasing microseismic activity along the Midlands Microcraton and the Anglo-Brabant massive geological formations that haven't shown significant movement for centuries. What's particularly alarming is the pattern of precursor earthquakes that typically precede major seismic events. Small tremors have been increasing in frequency along the Welsh borderland fault system, while previously quiet areas of northern England are showing unexplained seismic signatures. These warning signs mirror patterns observed before major earthquakes in other intraplate regions around the world. The most chilling aspect is how unprepared the general population remains. While California school children practice earthquake drills regularly, British students have never experienced a single earthquake preparedness exercise. Most UK households don't have emergency supplies, evacuation plans, or even basic knowledge of earthquake safety procedures. When the ground starts shaking violently, millions of people will have absolutely no idea how to respond. Government disaster management plans, while comprehensive on paper, rely on assumptions that simply don't apply to major seismic events. Emergency services are trained for floods, storms, and terrorist attacks, not for scenarios where every road, railway, and communication system fails simultaneously across hundreds of square miles. The scientific evidence is mounting, the geological stress is building, and the warning signs are multiplying. Yet, somehow, Britain continues sleepwalking toward a seismic disaster that could reshape the nation forever. The only question isn't if a major earthquake will strike, it's when and whether we'll be ready for the devastation that follows. Have you ever actually felt an earthquake in the UK, even a small one? Let me know what you think in the comments below. I'm genuinely curious about people's personal experiences.